Hey guys, this is Dan Seifer from MobileBurn.com, and what we've got here for you today is the new T-Mobile Sidekick 4G. We just got this bad boy in, so we're going to do a quick unboxing for you, give you a little hardware tour, and then take a look at the software, because there's a lot of software things that have been adjusted and stuff like that. As we know, this is the latest version of the Sidekick. It is T-Mobile's resurrection of the brand, and what they've done is teamed up with Samsung to produce the new phones that were formerly made by Sharp and Danger, and then also had some phones made by Motorola as well. But the big difference is now this guy runs Android. So why don't we rip it open, take a look at it, and see what we got. So opening up this box here, it's kind of funky. Got a pull tab, we got the Sidekick itself. Keep pulling the tab and you can lift the box out. And then you got your included accessories. Real quick, you got a micro USB cord for charging and data syncing and stuff like that. Over here we've got the AC adapter. Samsung has given us a single piece AC adapter. They've been giving out two piece units for a long time where they would have the USB cable that would plug into the plug and then that would plug into the wall and be used to charge, but this one comes with a separate device for that. And then over here we've got the SD card adapter. The phone itself comes with a 2GB SD card installed, so this little adapter so you can easily plug it into a card reader or into the reader on your computer. Inside this little flap here, we've got your standard documentation, manual, stuff like that, so that's pretty straightforward. And there is the packaging. Let's take a look at the device itself. So as you can see here, it's a very familiar looking Sidekick design. It's got nice size to it, but it's kind of chunky, kind of big. Got a 3.5 inch screen here. It's WVGA resolution, so it's 800 tall by 480 wide. Above that, you've got a front facing camera, and then you've got various sensors and notification lights over here. Your earpiece is up here, and then you've got an optical pad here. Now what you can see is there's buttons in each corners, three of which are common to many Android users. You've got your home button up here, menu button, back key, and then this new one over here is called the jump key, and we'll take a look at that a little later when we look at the software, but it is a much different function than what we're used to with Android. It does not offer the search function that you normally see with the fourth button on Android. Now for the star of the show, you can see we've got that great 5-row keyboard. It's really spacious, really massive. Buttons are great, buttons feel great, super easy to type on, really easy to pick up and use. Sidekick lovers, I think, will love it. It's definitely the heritage of the device. As you can see here, it's got this crazy flip mechanism. Oh. It's a little different than the Danger devices that we used to see from that were branded Sidekick that had the flipping rotating screen. This one's more of a straightforward flip out, but you can see the hinge here on the back. It's a very sturdy looking hinge, really solid feeling. Got some T-Mobile branding and Sidekick branding there. Doesn't look like it's going to present any issues as far as reliability. Really, really great feel to the screen, to the flipping mechanism here. Samsung did a really good job with it. While we're looking at the side here, you've got the micro USB charging port. Let's see if we can get that open. Right there. Camera keys over here. This looks like it's to be a lanyard loop there. And then over top, you've got nothing. On the other side of the phone, would be the left-hand side, you've got your 3.5mm headphone jack, volume up and down keys. This is actually your power, your wake-up key, stuff like that. I don't know if you can really see in the video, but it does not look like a power key at all. Took me a few minutes to find that when I first picked up the device, but that's where it is. It's on the lower left-hand corner if you're holding the phone in portrait orientation. Down on the bottom side, you really got nothing except for a microphone port, and then the little notch to lift off the battery cover. The back side, this is where you see your Samsung branding, it's right there. Then you've got the 3-megapixel camera. It's autofocus but no flash. And it looks like we've got some speaker grill down here. Underneath the battery cover, you got your 1500 milliamp battery from Samsung, and on the side here is the micro SD card slot for the 2GB card that's included. Now that's a real quick tour of the hardware of the Sidekick 4G. It's a really solid feeling phone as far as the hardware build quality goes. I think Samsung did a really great job putting this together. It's a little chunky and a little big, but if you're a Sidekick fan or had a Sidekick way back when, that's not going to be any surprise to you. Most importantly, that screen flipping mechanism is really solid, and the keyboard is really spacious and big. They've included shortcut keys for the voice dialing, voice commands from Android. You got an emoticon key here, a nice at key shortcut right there, which is quick and easy to access. And it's always nice having the extra row for the numbers right there on the top. Alright, so that was a quick look at the hardware. We're going to dive into the software in just a moment. Alright, so we've got the Sidekick powered up and set up with a few accounts so we can demo the software here for you. Now what you're going to see when you first turn it on is it really is a familiar Android interface here. We've got your standard panes of home screens. There's 7 total with this one. You can swipe between them. You've got some standard Android widgets that we're used to seeing. You can fill it up with widgets and shortcuts just like with any other Android phone. It supports the pinch gesture here, so you can see your home screens laid out in a grid like so, and you can tap and hold them, rearrange them. If you don't particularly want a home screen, you can drag it down to the trash can and delete it. Nice little home screen things that we're used to seeing with a lot of other implementations of Android. This particular phone runs Android 2.2, so it's Froyo. So you do get a lot of the Froyo features and enhancements that you're used to seeing on it. Down at the bottom, you'll see the first types of customizations that has been done for the Sidekick phone. You got shortcuts, kind of like a customized launcher here, phone, apps, and contacts. That's going to bring up your standard phone dialer, of course, where you can select the different options up here. Access voicemail settings, let's forget that though, and such. Samsung and T-Mobile have really customized kind of this whole interface look here throughout the OS. So you'll see these kind of angled things going on. It's kind of cool looking. It's kind of modern in my opinion, but you'll see that repeated quite a bit throughout the operating system. If we tap the apps, we're going to see the apps come up in a familiar grid here, just like TouchWiz on Samsung's other products. It does a left to right app drawer as opposed to up and down that you see with other Android devices. You're going to see a lot of TouchWiz implementation throughout the OS here. It's not full TouchWiz, it's definitely customized specifically for the Sidekick, but there's a lot of TouchWiz elements that we see, and one of them here is definitely the app drawer. Contacts is your standard contacts, but it does sync and integrate with your social networks, so you can integrate it with Twitter and Facebook and even MySpace. Sports groups, you can get a history of your contacts, calls received, sent, stuff like that. And then over here you can see updates from social networks that you might have in your contacts and stuff like that. Let's go back home. If we swipe down at the top here, you're going to have your standard notification panel from Android. If we had any notifications there, they would pop up right there. But what you also have is a new quick update option here. So you can tap this and easily update your status to various social networks. So you can just select the social network that you want, type in what you want, and then just click send, and it will be posted to the social network. So it's a real quick, easy way to do status updates and stuff like that. You can also hit this little pink button down here in the lower left and switch the type of message that you're sending. So if you wanted to compose a text message quickly and easily, you can do that right from there. You can switch to an email very quickly and easily if you got an email account set up. That does not work through the standard Gmail account that is present here, but you can use it through a different email account. Back over at the status update bar, the notification pull down, if you hit this little blue arrow, you get those little shortcuts that you're used to seeing with Galaxy S phones. on TouchWiz and stuff like that. You can turn on and off your Bluetooth, your Wi-Fi, your GPS, your rotation, stuff like that. Your ring mode right there, quickly and easily, right from the notification bar, which is always a nice touch.